Good morning, fans of PrivateerFX. Coming at you on a Tuesday, 25 September. About an hour and a half before the European Open. Let's take a look what happened yesterday. Draghi had some sort of mildly egotistical, slightly bullish. It wasn't so bullish. I think the market just got caught short. Took us up to about 16. As you can see, we closed at 50. Opened where we closed. Now we have this confluence of signals here. Yesterday's low, 25. The death knock here of the break, the trend line break, which was 24. And we have this upward sloping trend line. It's only really a two touches twice, but defines it nicely. Comes in at 11. We're going to use 20 as the number. Because even though we were traveling, we know 20 was the number on the way up on Thursday. And I'm going to get short some euros. We're short Aussie from yesterday, as we said. Between 70 and 80 paid there. There's no reason to cut this now. You can start trading it because there's sort of a, there's going to be some support. 72.20, 72.28. So this is a tradable short now. Core short works. Dollar CAD the same. Been stubborn, this dollar CAD. Holy cow, I was like pulling my hair out yesterday when we were down at 10. But has come good. We do like this to kind of push up to 131.70 for FOMC tomorrow. So again, core long, dollar CAD, core short euro. Dollars are, we do like longs. Didn't quite get to like some crazy low buy zone. It'd be nice for us to make a higher high one of these days. It's been a long time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 days we haven't had a higher high. 43.80. 42.70 yesterday's low. Interesting. We're biding our time here. We want to be long dollar czar. We may nip in for something tiny. But we're waiting for something beautiful to appear on the charts. This isn't quite beautiful. But, you know, this is so short term, it's not that great. But you can see where I'm going with this. You can try to check this guy here. Very short term, that smacks of desperation. Got to be patient. There's always another trade, and keep in mind if the best trade for dollars are is 115, it's 1506. That's fine. We're here just to make money. We're not always here to be right. Sounds weird, but timing and execution are a big part of this, and so you don't want to sit. You don't have to be sit like dollar CAD yesterday, not a great trade. You know, we sat through a lot of pain, you know, between sort of 38 and 10. Whereas Aussie, much better, much tidier, right? I think 76 was the high. Anyway, moving on. We're looking to buy dollar rand. We'll see what happens. A couple other charts worth mentioning, Aussie yen. Consolidation here between 82 the figure and 81.60. This looks like it's heading lower. We made a new high today, so we're bearish engulfing through 60. This looks like a break trade to me, 81.60. I bet you a nickel that Privateer will be there at 59, fooling around. Same type of chart in CAD yen. Obviously, the reason these things haven't turned is dollar yen has gone bid going into FOMC. We'll have to see if we can make a new high here. These are very important levels, 113.20. I'm not really feeling it in dollar yen. I guess because I'm mildly risk off. So we're leaving dollar yen alone. Speaking of risk off, we got to a low of 17 and 3/4 yesterday, which is kind of cool. That's the triple top from before. For those of you, all these highs, 1, 2, 3. It's a beautiful pivot now. Daily close below 18, and things are looking a little ropey. If you put your visualization little goggles on, are we heading for a big red day on Wednesday? And Powell is maybe a little too hawkish. I don't know. But my visualization glasses are saying that, even though they're tinted with bias. Something to think about. Today we're going to just trade this Aussie and dollar CAD. So we're core short Aussie, core long dollar CAD. We're going to enter into Euro shorts down through 20. And looking to nip into some dollar rand. And watching these cross yen levels in Aussie yen and CAD yen. Sounds like a lot on the plate. But it's not really, you know, the core shorts are already kind of in play. The real execution issue comes with euro dollar. That's going to be a very tricky entry. And then you want to just keep your eye on these cross yens. And if dollar yen is bid and about to make new highs, be very careful. You want everything. You want the story and the chart to agree on these. So basically, you want S&P's lower. All right, I've said enough, people. I wish you well today. Good luck. Make some money. And I will talk to you tomorrow. Flip some stuff onto Twitter as I see.